Planning to play some board games this holiday break? Math can help you win by developing a more competitive strategy. In this quick video, we offer two math-based strategies for the popular board game, Ticket to Ride. Ticket to Ride is a train-building game where you build trains between cities by using different colored cards, including wild cards, and you get points for those trains. The longer the train, the more points you get. You can also get points for completing destination routes and even get bonus points for having the longest fully connected train route amongst the players. But don't get too ambitious with your destination routes, because you lose points if you have a destination card that you're not able to complete by the end of the game. The last round starts when one person builds a train and has two or fewer trains left. At that point, each person gets one last turn. A player has one of three things they can do for their turn. They can draw cards, they can turn in cards to build a train to connect two cities, or they can take a set of destination cards. The first strategy we'll talk about is to build long trains. There are a lot of advantages to building long roads in this game. First, they offer better point efficiency. We can see in this table how trains with more cars correspond with higher point values per car. A 6-car train is worth 15 points, and that's 2.5 points per car, while shorter trains like 1 or 2 cars only give 1 point per car. The second advantage of building long trains is that you can end the game quicker, causing others to fail in completing destination routes and leaving trains unbuilt, which costs them points. The reason you end the game quicker is because it takes you fewer turns to use your trains, plus every time you build, you lose the chance to draw cards, and more cards is a huge advantage in this game. In one hypothetical comparison, we found a system with 3 6-car trains took 12 build turns versus 15 build turns for a system with no 6-car trains and shorter builds. In each case, they needed 45 trains, but that 3-turn difference allows you to finish first, causing the other player to lose points to incomplete routes, and you potentially earn the bonus for the longest train. Lastly, near the end of the game, prioritize building a long road over risky destination cards. A 6-car road often outpoints most destinations, and you avoid the gamble of picking routes you can't complete. So though you don't always have complete freedom, try to keep destination routes with long train sections to really maximize your points. The second strategy is to use optimal geometry. By optimizing the geometry of your routes, you'll use fewer trains and fewer builds, which allows you to then complete even more destinations. Ticket to Ride is a point connecting game. You have multiple cities that you want to connect with the fewest cars. Although you don't have to have a connected system, it is usually an advantage since some trains can be used to complete multiple destinations. Mathematicians have already worked out the mathematics for connecting points with the minimum length required. These can give you a good starting point to build your trains without analyzing all possible paths. The optimal path to connect 3 points is usually with a Y shape. If those 3 points lie relatively close to a line, then connecting them in sequence is the best. But let's consider the harder case, when they're not relatively close to a line. Here are 3 points, and you might think that the shortest path might be when each segment is close to equal length. But in this case, the optimal connection point is pretty far from here. The color of the point changes to blue in this example when it's close to the optimal point. If we look at the angles when we are near the optimal point, they're all close to 120 degrees. With multivariable calculus, we could prove the optimal intersection point is when the 3 segments intersect at 100 degree angles. Now that's more technical than needed for Ticket to Ride, but it gives a good rule of thumb to start. For example, if we want to connect Seattle, Toronto, and New Orleans, we should make direct routes from each destination to Kansas City or maybe St. Louis. These seem like the closest to having equal angles with straight lines to the destinations, but St. Louis does look like the better option. Usually I'm not faced with connecting 3 points, usually I'm connecting 4 or more. For 4, we still use 120 degree angles, but with a different shape called the Steiner H. We could start by making an H to connect the 4 points, but then we can apply our knowledge of 3 points. To optimally connect this intersection and these 2 destination points, we know we need an intersection with 3 120 degree angles. So we move the intersection towards the middle. Then we do the same with the other intersection points and these 2 opposite destination points. This is the connection of the least length to connect all 4 points. I found this quite useful in Ticket to Ride when I have destinations in the 4 corners of the map. If you have Seattle, Los Angeles, New Orleans, and Toronto, then you want to look for a path like this for a good chance to use the fewest train cars. From there, I build spurs or detours to connect other cities if I have more destinations. These 2 strategies are sometimes at odds with each other. you may choose to do a longer path and not the shortest connecting path in order to get a longer train with more points. Or you may play to the card colors in your hand and take a longer path that doesn't require you to use more turns drawing cards. Ticket to Ride is a complex game and you have to be flexible, but now you have two strategies to use to help give you the best chance to win. Do you have other strategies for Ticket to Ride? Put them in the comments. And if you try one of these strategies that we've talked about, let us know how it works in the comments as well. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and share our videos. Be sure to follow Math the World on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Thank you so much for your support.